So today I'm joining the $50,000 investing challenge with ChatGPT. That's right, a D, like BDE, big dividend energy. Today I'm joining the $50,000 investing challenge to see if ChatGPT can make me money. And in today's video, you're gonna watch me copy and recreate 5 of the world's most famous investment portfolios, including Warren Buffett's, Nancy Pelosi's, Michael Burry's, and more. And I'm gonna show you how I'm doing it step by step using AI tools that will do this for us automatically. But first, what's ChatGPT? I know it should seem obvious for those of us on the internet, but believe it or not, according to a recent survey from Finder.com where they polled 2,000 people, 38% of people didn't even know what ChatGPT was. So for those not in the know, ChatGPT is an AI. It's a language learning model, and it's basically Skynet before Skynet was self-aware. It doesn't yet know it's about to take over humanity and rule over us, but it's about to. And it's getting smarter and smarter every single day, especially with numbers, data, and of course, investing.
But now the active managers potentially face a fresh challenge, funds managed by artificial intelligence. The fund consisting of 38 stocks chosen by ChatGPT has, in the last 7 weeks, outperformed the average of the UK's 10 most popular funds.
They recently conducted an experiment where they fed it the latest economic data, things like interest rates, what's going on with housing, and they trained it on some basic financial literacy just to see what it would do. They let this experiment run for 45 days, and it picked 38 random stocks that it thought would do well. Stocks like Johnson & Johnson, Microsoft, Visa, Meta, Netflix, etc. And between March 6th and April 28th of this year, it was competing against the top 10 most popular funds in the world. Funds from names you've probably heard of before. Names like Vanguard, Fidelity, and HSBC. Now, 35% of the people polled said they never even consider using ChatGPT for investing advice, but it turns out ChatGPT outperformed those top 10 funds in 40 out of the 45 days they ran the experiment. In other words, it outperformed 89% of the time, and it even outperformed the golden standard of investing, the S&P 500 index, which was up only 3% during the same time period versus its 4.6%. So there is so much excitement about what these AI tools can do to the world of investing. And starting today, there's a new plugin called Portfolio Pilot where it'll connect to an app which will connect to your favorite brokerage where anyone can try this themselves. And I think this could turn the world of investing upside down. So I'm super excited to try this out, build these portfolios, and see where they take us. So let's get into it. Hi, my name is Andrei Jikh. Hope you're doing well. Come for the finance and stay for the AI. Do me a favor, smash the like button, AI style, actually D-Lite style. I don't know why I did that. But if this video gets to 10,000 likes, I will make a follow-up video on what will happen to this portfolio on the next season finale of AI's Gone Wild. So this was started by the CEO of Autopilot, and if you're interested in keeping up with this experiment, you can follow their Twitter account here, but my video is not sponsored in any way, shape, or form. They are not paying me to make this video. In fact, they don't even know I exist. This was actually sent to me by my friend Dylan from Curious Future, so go check him out. But I thought it was interesting, especially because there's nothing else this week, and sometimes you gotta do reckless things like magic tricks and becoming a content creator.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
So let's get started. First, I'm gonna have to download the Autopilot app on my phone from the App Store. I've already done that, and if you wanna try this experiment yourself, follow along, and it's about to blow your mind. So this app is called Autopilot, and when I was preparing for this video, I've never heard of this app. This is my first time downloading it and trying it out, but what it does is it allows you to copy and recreate some of the world's most famous investment portfolios, including the Jim Cramer with the inverse Cramer Mutual Fund. So whatever Jim Cramer does, they do the opposite. It's crazy because they track Jim Cramer's stock picks based on a show on CNN, what he's posting on Twitter, but what's insane is that last year this fund made 34%. That's insane when you consider the fact that the S&P 500 lost about 19%. But wait, there's more. It also allows you to follow and copy and recreate arguably the most famous congresswoman in the world, Nancy Pelosi, with the Pelosi tracker. Winner, winner, chicken dinner, because her average is 31%, which is insanely impressive. Now, last year her portfolio lost 5%, but hey, we can't all be perfect inside traders. I kid, of course. Now, hold on a minute, how does this app know what she's buying and selling? If you click the little eye at the upper right-hand corner, you'll be able to see that it tells you that's because of something called the Stock Act, which requires every congressperson to disclose what they're buying and what they're selling within 45 days of doing so. Now, for Nancy Pelosi, she discloses on average roughly 14 days after she invests, which is why you see that 14 days under average delay. But wait, there's more. This app also allows you to follow and copy the one, the only legendary investor, Warren Buffett, with the Buffett Tracker. Now, his returns are nowhere near as high as some of his esteemed colleagues at only 12%, but that's still really impressive because let's see what your returns look like after a 50-year career with all your Bitcoin. Anyway, if you click the information in the upper right-hand corner, you'll also be able to see that the reason they know what his holdings are is because of Form 13F, which forces the hedge funds to disclose their positions within 45 days of the last day of the calendar quarter. Now, this is also how they're able to get the Burry Tracker. This, of course, is the famous Michael Burry who predicted the global 2008 financial crisis, and here you can see his entire portfolio, and you can see his yearly averages 50% with 60% made last year, which to me is just mind-blowing when you consider the fact that the stock market is supposed to return 8 to 10% on average. So this guy is doing 5 times better than the average. There's also the Citadel Tracker, very similar returns at 45%, last year 49%. If you're not sure what Citadel is, it is the number one most profitable hedge fund manager of all time with Kenneth Griffin as their CEO. But the one I really want is that sweet GUI, that sweet AI, that ChatGPT. So that's what I'm gonna focus on. Now, I'm gonna put $1,000 into every one of these, but this plugin will be made available specifically for ChatGPT starting today. But Andre, I thought you were gonna put in $50,000 of your own money. No, they are of their money. I'm not that desperate for views yet, is the key word. So first I'm gonna set this up with ChatGPT and then I'll do it for all of the other ones. But it was pretty straightforward. All I did was click the plus button at the bottom of the app. Then I hit ChatGPT. And again, on the bottom it says select ChatGPT trader. Now, once that's confirmed, it asks to connect the broker and it lists Robinhood, Webull, TD Ameritrade. I know, Andre, only use Robinhood if you're an amateur. Fortunately, I am, so I do. Now, once that's connected, you select the account you wanna pull the money from, you pick exactly how much money you wanna invest. $500 is the minimum, which is kind of steep. To make it fun, I put in $1,000, which I'll do for all the other ones as well. And once that's done, just swipe up to confirm, and it's pretty easy and straightforward. Unfortunately, this app is kind of expensive at $30 every 3 months. Now, I'm not sponsored by them, so I'll be paying this $120 a year. Again, that doesn't sound like a lot, but don't calculate the cost of this using your hourly earnings and tell yourself, oh, that's like 3 to 4 hours of working. Don't use your active day job income. Use your passive income to calculate the true cost of this, because at $120 a year, divided by 4%, if you had a portfolio that's generating 4%, how much do you need invested to make $120 a year? That is a $3,000 portfolio. So if you have that, that is the true cost to allow this thing to exist in your life. Now, I am a content creator, so for me, this is a taxable write-off, and it's worth it for me just for the content, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's worth it for everyone. So just calculate it before you do and ask yourself twice before you pay for this, because maybe you should let me lose the money first. But Andre, ChatGPT isn't even connected to the internet. It's not gonna be useful. And those are good concerns, but from what I understand of this experiment, they're gonna be feeding it articles manually from the internet, as well as connecting APIs from the news organizations and training it and keeping it up to date with macroeconomic information like interest rates, the housing market, the GDP, unemployment, things like that, just to make sure that it has all of the context and it's aware of it. Now, they're also gonna be focusing on companies with $300 million in market cap or bigger. Now, each of their stocks will also need to be fed multiple articles about it almost every single day. And if this was done manually, this would be a massive undertaking that would almost be impossible unless they had a huge team behind them. But from my understanding, most of the information that they'll be collecting will be done automatically behind the scenes by collecting those APIs that will gather and farm those headlines from the news articles. Now, using this methodology, they're going to create a scoring system that will try to find the top 20 stocks with the best market sentiment, aka the stocks that people feel the most excited about in the future, and they'll be buying them roughly every 3 days. Now, they'll also try to leverage negative sentiment, and they'll try to invest in those inverse ETFs, kind of like the way the Jim Cramer ETF works. So that is the methodology, and it starts today. Now, I have no clue how this will perform, but that's also why I didn't invest $50,000. It could do incredibly well, or it could do really bad, or be somewhere in the middle. I know, it's a genius move. But really, my goal is just to beat Graham Stephan's stock monkey portfolio. That's all I want. Leveraging all the tools that humanity has created, I want to beat Graham's Mojo Jojo. Little Powerpuff Girls reference for all the millennials out there. Anyway, I discourage anyone from trying this, but in the meantime, focus on your own investment journey. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Smash the like button, subscribe if you haven't already. Don't forget to grab your free stocks. Links are down below, and then go track them automatically with the spreadsheet linked down below in my Patreon. Love you. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'd love to see you back here on Monday, Friday, sometimes a Wednesday. See you soon. Bye-bye.